I was talking to my friend about the pallets of bricks that are lining up at Santa Monica. The kind of synthesized relationship between the problem systemic and the police force. And I don't mean racism in thereof. I'm talking about the authoritarian sense of authoritarianism without fear of reprisal, without the fronde, without the ability of the public to rise up and question police that take measures that are inherently subjective to the precept of probability. Someone that is black in a certain neighborhood is up to no good, and I can question them and possibly arrest them for loitering or something nonsensical, and just have that notch in my belt. Like, those things are unacceptable. But the synthesizing of revolution, the Saul Alinsky manual, Rules for Radicals, which everyone should read, about how unlikely it is for the masses, the proletariat, to the precariat, the poor and impoverished, socioeconomically oppressed, to come together. And you see free market, private money invested heavily in these riots, and Antifa, and busing people in to break stores. Kind of like an investment in the fall and decay of the West. Federalization of the police force, which is just one step further to police acting as bobbies, not people having weapons, which is just one step closer to the Second Amendment being compromised. These things are dangerous. And then you have a media that is bifurcated in every sense of the word. Their monies. It was just NBC, ABC, CBS, major networks, cable got into the play, and now you have everything on the media, internets and all that can just take money away from this power center. The CIA used to have, maybe they still do, and this is sort of my point, Operation Mockingbird, which is a propaganda machine vis-a-vis the media conglomerates of pushing information. The DoD project that was Google, with the purpose of trying to anticipate what the populace is thinking through searches, is disconcerting. Some of the grants that YouTube received, disconcerting. The suggestion that anti-fascism or the idea of free speech and protective speech for the sake of the greater good is a precept in line with the First Amendment, or a textualist understanding from our founding fathers, or a live constitutional application of what they would want in this day and age. I see a populace of young people and millennials that are essentially being culled by very powerful people designed solely to make sure that they don't have power or control. Basically, subsidizing the middle class lifestyle through the government. The left, the Democrats, have a very strong advantage in this regard, with the blue collar workforce slowly falling by the wayside because their inability to code, to essentially provide for themselves in an economy that is inherently going to be automated. It's very scary. So when I think about these pallets of bricks in Santa Monica, when I think about the amount of people that are being paid to protest via Craigslist and such, perpetuated by some companies like Media Matters, an Austrian Jew that sold out Jews during the Holocaust for the sake of his own ends. Not going to say a name because it just sounds like, oh, I sound like a right-wing crazy person. I'm not. I'm socially liberal, but I'm libertarian when it comes to the idea that the U.S. government being bigger and stronger, the federal government, is essential for helping everyone else. The idea that, like, we as citizens can't do it ourselves. We have to defer the want. We can have the want, we have to defer the means to an end to this giant organization. Big Brother, huge Orwellian facility, and that our monies should be taxed more therein, again, taking more power away from the people to a centralized state, something certainly Jefferson wouldn't want. If he saw the federal government's debt, he would be shocked and appalled. This world is very originality, freedom of thought. Everything is kind of convoluted in the sense of the visor that we see things through is constantly being filtered. Nothing is real as we know it. An SSRI to having B vitamins in the morning can alter our perceptions for the day. And then you have all these other filters that have, you know, means and ends of themselves, from the newspapers to media to the inherent idealism of doing good to others is completely contradictory and anachronistic to everything that we know about nature and the real world. And the baby boomers are such an important people to get under the progressive belt, like the 1968 Democratic Conventions, the Dunnan and other Democratic pushers were trying to say, listen, let's screw the blue-collar worker, let's go after the flower child, the anti-war people. Let's get the blacks and all these minority groups together. And inherently, in summation, we have this large voting bloc now that we can use and go after. You know, means and ends. This is a, you know, immigration. Well, we care about, you know, immigrants coming here and, like, you know, children, you know, minors that are at the border. It's our responsibility. It's right, because it's not the responsibility of the parent. It's not the incentive as to why would you want all these mass people to come here, uneducated, impoverished, without skills, and subsidize their living. Well, because they vote Democrat. They vote a certain way. They are become subjects of the federal government, and they pledge allegiance to that end. Our government is not impartial. And just as you saw with the passing of the Patriot Act measures in the Senate during a national disaster, like they can look at your browsing history without getting a warrant, that should raise some concerns for some people.